you're like the lone person that's actually, you know, saying the truth about these Chinese virus numbers. And we're learning in not only in Arizona, but in Texas as well. I mean, deaths are way down. It looks like herd immunity is building because more cases are coming up. It's for younger people that, you know, unless this virus figures out how to kill people 30 and under and even under 40, it's not going to be nearly as bad as anything else. Yet we're scared that we might have, you know, even more shutdowns. Who knows?
Yeah, you know, I mean, so the highest death toll we had in any individual day was weeks and weeks ago at 34. You know, on July 4th, the reported death rate was 1. On last Friday, it was 1. The day before that, it was 1. So you see this, and that case fatality rate has gone down. Even yesterday, is about just a little under 1.8%. And a few weeks ago, right at the start of opening up, it wasn't due to the opening up because there's a lag time there, it was over 4%. So you see by the actual reduction in rate is something in an order of 140% of the case fatality rate over the last 3.5 weeks.
So now that we know this, and it's going down, I mean, again, there are more cases because we're doing, you know, a bunch more tests. So obviously when you do more tests, you're going to get more cases. But yet Doug Ducey, our governor, wants to blame people going to bars. Like you said, instead of the riots, the protests, he wants to blame opening up businesses. And now businesses are fighting back. So what I just said, like you comment on, and then, you know, look in your crystal ball, what do you think is going to happen today with the lawsuit, Mountainside Fitness and EOS Fitness against Doug Ducey's executive order?
Yeah, no, I talked to the owner of Mountainside Fitness last week. I think his suit is righteous. This is arbitrary and capricious, where you'd say we're going to close down bars and swimming pools and tubing on the Salt River, for instance. It's not even rationally tied. And this is, even if you give this a rational basis test, which is a legal term, analysis here, this is not, there's no rational basis to this arbitrary and capriciousness. So you've got a whole host of constitutional issues with what he's done. My biggest concern, Garrett, is I do not want him, after he loses the case, which I think he's going to lose, the governor's going to lose today, after he loses this, say, okay, well, then we're going to shut down everybody. That would be just disastrous. And the numbers certainly don't warrant that in Arizona. And the social pathologies and the public health crisis that we've created with these lockdowns would just be exacerbated on that side. And nobody's talking about that too much either.
Well, yeah. So, I mean, here's the thing. If he, you know, and I don't know what is going on with Doug Ducey. I don't know. He's going after business more than I've ever seen. It's like he's the Michigan governor. If he does get even more crazy with power and get mad, what can be done? Because even the Senate president and the Speaker of the House here in Arizona, both Republicans, haven't recalled the legislature to try to rein this guy in and get, you know, equal powers back.
Well, under the Arizona Constitution, for the legislature to call itself back in, they need a supermajority. And they can't get a supermajority because it's so close. Like in the House, it's 31 R's to 29 D's. So they can't get a supermajority to call him in. They need the governor to call him in. And the governor's not going to call him in because he knows that they're going to respond and say, look, you can't keep shutting down our businesses. Now, one of those bodies, is merely in recess, technically. So. But the other body has to also have a supermajority. So it's a conundrum when you see this happening. And so I would suspect you're going to see more litigation coming based on the outcome. If this comes favorable for Mountainside and EOS today, I would imagine you're going to see more litigation because that may be our only resort of resolving this thing is in the courts.
Well, and I tell you, I had a lawyer send me another lawsuit. It was 8 different plaintiffs, yoga studios, gyms, going after Ducey's. Well, these are 8 new ones. And I've been told there's even more on the way. So,
I'm hearing that too. We're both seeing that. So, yeah.
So I guess there's really not, unless the judges say you've gone over the line, Governor Ducey can't do this. If he goes full revenge mode, there's really not much that anybody could do to stop him, huh?
No, it would really be extremely difficult. you know, so I've heard people say recall. Well, the recall at this point would take you, you couldn't get the signatures probably. But if you, even if you did get the signatures, you'd be rolling out months after this crisis is over. So that becomes irrelevant as well. What we need is we need Democrats in the state legislature to say, look, you know what, enough's enough. But I don't think you're going to get that.
No, I don't think. And it's, how strange is that? I mean, we know they don't like business anyway, and they're backing the Republican governor. This is crazy. Congressman Andy Biggs is on KNST AM 790. So the numbers just show around the country that, I mean, the virus, the death rate is even lower than we thought. More people have it than we realize. There's so many cases of asymptomatic cases. But one thing that I keep hearing from doctors, and I have a bunch of doctors contacting me, is that they suspect bad things going on at hospitals in Arizona, where they are just doing everything they can to label everything COVID. Like basically, like there's fraud going on. I mean, is there going to be any kind of investigation after this? Because hospitals are loving it because they're saying everybody is a COVID case. I mean, I've at least a dozen calls every show where people talk about people dying and it's listed as COVID, even though they didn't die from COVID. They go into the hospital with a broken leg, they come out and it's COVID. And I tested negative. Well, it doesn't matter. False negative, you have COVID. Because they're getting extra reimbursement. Can anything be done about this?
Yeah, so one of the problems is that under the CARES Act, which I voted no on, one of the problems was is it allowed CMS to give up to 20 to 25% higher reimbursement rate on every COVID case. So you just incentivized the medical world to look for COVID cases because as you treat COVID cases, and particularly with fatalities, you get more money, more reimbursement. And I'm a big believer that people respond to incentives for good or bad. So we've created this incentive in the federal. CMS is the Center for Medicare and Medicaid Services. And so they're the ones that determine the reimbursements. And Congress gave them authority to pay more. So that's why you see that incentive out there, and that's why you see this going on. I've talked to the administration, and I'm told that, I mean, it's not like this administration doesn't have a thousand things on the plate, but I've told them that my suggestion is that there needs to be an investigation into this, and they agree, they concur. It's just finding resources to be able to do that.
Gosh, you know, and doctors tell me, Congressman, that if you got rid of the CARES Act tomorrow, all of a sudden you'd see all these numbers of COVID patients go down like crazy and hospitals
yes,
empty out,
true.
Even though they're not that they're not that busy to begin with, because most, like Dr. Atlas said, I don't know if you saw the interview. He said on Friday in a TV interview, he said that only 15% of the inpatient beds in Texas are COVID patients. But people are acting like we're just exploding and hospitals can't handle this.
Yeah, no, I mean, that's, In Arizona, I think it's a higher percentage rate. If you believe the DHS numbers, it's a higher percentage is COVID, but it's still not driving us beyond the levels that you cited earlier today. I mean, just think of it. The highest number in seriousness, Garrett, you got to understand this. When you look at the highest number of hospitalizations in a day in Arizona, that was back the middle of June, 96, according to DHS data. 96 was the highest number we ever brought in. You know how many we discharged yesterday? 475. We discharged 475. The day before that, 458. The day before that, 425. And we have discharged over 200 people a day now for just about 2 weeks. And the highest number we've ever hospitalized with COVID, as reported by DHS, is 96.
This is incredible. Congressman Andy Biggs on KNST, AIM 790. And then Doug Ducey, our governor, decided to push the school opening back 2 weeks, just about, I think 11 days. Yet in Florida, they just mandated that schools open on time at least 5 days a week. What a difference right there. I mean, Ron DeSantis in Florida is doing a bang-up job. He's not scared. He had a press conference yesterday where he said, look, I'm not going to ban anything right now because it's just not needed. Let's just calm down with the hysteria. I mean, again, look at the difference between right now, Arizona and Florida. I never thought I'd say that.
Yeah, no, Ron's doing a great job. I mean, he is really being a leader on this. He's saying, look, no, we're going to do what he's going to follow the science and the data. And the science and data says open up schools. They open them up all over Europe. We just can't open them up here. And I just put a plug here. Freedom Caucus is going to do a town hall this Thursday, 10 a.m. Arizona time, with pediatricians and experts talking about the need to open up schools. And so, you know, if you get a chance, it's going to be a teletown hall on that. So that'll be a good thing. But I'm just telling you, right now, you've got teachers' unions that are saying we don't want to open up because they're nervous. They're claiming that they're fearful. But the data is real clear on this thing. And not only that, the American Academy of Pediatrics said last week, they said, look, we have already seen that there's more damage caused to children by keeping them out of school from the spring and they need to get back into school. They need to get back into school. They're going to fall further and further behind. This is astonishing to me, the remaking of our society we're seeing here because of this.
Yeah, and you know, I was actually took a couple days off and was up in the Scottsdale area just to escape, and went out with the family to walk around. And I'm not refusing to wear a mask to be a jerk. I just know they don't do anything, and I don't like it. It makes it hard to breathe. I don't like it. But I'm really disappointed in seeing how many people actually are wearing it. Like they're just, it's almost like what, you know, the communist Chinese tell their citizens to do something and they give in right away and have to do it. And this is kind of like I see what's going on here.
No, you're right. I mean, I've said this for a couple months now. I'm surprised at how quickly Americans acquiesced to unconstitutional intrusions in their lives and the reduction and encroachment on their rights. It's just amazing. I mean, you go into, look, if I went out to a restaurant, my wife and I went out to a restaurant to eat yesterday specifically because they said, we don't require our staff or patrons to wear masks here. We said, well, that's a place I want to go. I'm going to feel comfortable there. But we actually, I've had people try to surreptitiously film me, video me, I'm old school, film me, video me in a restaurant. You know, as I wait for my food without a mask, they're videoing me to do what? To try and shame me. That's bizarre behavior in a free country. That's more like communist. Go back and read what happened in Soviet Russia. Go find out what happens in China, where you have communism as your rule of law. It is, they ask you to inform on your neighbors. And that's, our leaders are doing that in this country today.
Yeah, they really are. By the way, was that restaurant, were they threatened by the Ducey administration for not having their wait staff and employees wear masks?
I don't know. I wanted to talk to the manager who was not in when we were there yesterday.
Okay. And by the way, have you ever reached out to the Ducey administration? Were you able to talk to the governor about why he is making these decisions? Is he willing to talk to you? Because we're all trying to figure out what's going on in his mind.
It's been a good while since I've had an opportunity to talk to him. I really don't know who's advising him. I don't know where this comes from. If you're concerned, I mean, the rational thing here is to say, 12% of the cases are in the elderly who have comorbidities, and yet there's something of the order of 2/3 of the fatalities in Arizona. Well, wouldn't you think that's where you would put your resources? That's who you would really try to, if you're going to quarantine anybody, that's who you'd quarantine. But, you know, even them, they've got rights. They've got rights to circulate and as well. The whole thing is just bizarre because if you're under 44, fatality rate is really low. If you're under 20, it's almost non-existent. The test rate is up. New cases are up, hospitalizations are down, fatalities. None of this makes sense to me, Garrett. I mean, you follow the science. Look at the science and the data. It's very clear. Masks don't work. I haven't seen a study yet, and we look at studies regularly in my office. We haven't seen a study yet that says, yeah, if you wear a mask, it's going to work.
There is nothing. Really quick, last couple of things. I know we're running short on time, Congressman. I appreciate it. Congressman Andy Biggs on KNST AM 790. The great Alex Berenson tweeted out this morning, if Arizona, Florida, and Texas really start to roll over the next 10 days, meaning everything starts to go down even more, where does Team Apocalypse go next? Like, what is there? And, you know, if all of a sudden the deaths continue to drop, testing goes up, and we, you know, again, so we're getting close to herd immunity. We should be getting there. What happens next? And on top of that, shouldn't we have, and didn't the governor, you know, brag a couple months ago that if we have a major explosion, we have St. Luke's and all kinds of temporary hospitals able to be built just like that?
Yeah, I mean, seriously, if we were to have a surge here, I believe Arizona's ready for it. I mean, you looking and talking to folks in the field, and they that's what they're telling me. Yeah, we're ready. Don't forget too. I mean, some hospitals actually closed because of the lack of patients. They closed wings. And have they reopened those wings? Are those beds included in the available beds? What's the staffing levels? Are they including all their staff when they talk about what's an available bed? Are you factoring in the Santa Cruz County, Yuma County, which are having cross-border influx of transmission? I mean, all of this stuff really gets to it. And Alex is really good on this, and he's right. If we go down another 10 days, what's the next panic going to be? It actually, when he says that, it is infused with the notion that in many ways this is a political attack on red state governors that are also swing states for this president and for the Senate and getting back the House. That's what this is about in some respects. We've reached that point.
Yep, we have. Congressman Andy Biggs, thank you for being one of the few people with common sense and out there trying to inform everyone about this virus and not go with the insanity and the panic. Thank you very much, sir. I appreciate it.